Kia ora and welcome to today's video. Today we're doing something a little different. We are preparing a palette. So I've had this palette for ages. It was $3 from like a $2 shop kind of vibe. I know, a little contradictory there, but the point is we'll be pouring the palette together. I thought it'd be quite interesting, quite fun. You can see what kind of paint I have on here today. I've chosen, it took me a little while to like figure out what ones I actually wanted, but this will be the palette I will take with me down south, so I guess we'll just get started. We've got a range of paints. We've got, let me just focus on this one. Oh, maybe we won't focus in on this one. This is a Loreline yellow, and this was actually really cheap. It was like for sale. It was like, I think it was discounted. It was like, I think they were trying to get rid of it, and I was like, you know what, I won't complain. So I got it. The theory was this would be my like lemon kind of yellow. It's a little off from a lemon yellow, a little separated as well. The thoughts there. Let me just mix it in a little bit. I won't fill them up this much, like for all of them, but it's just yellow is a very used color, so it makes sense to have a lot of yellow. But yeah, this will be a good yellow to have. I might actually change. This is New Gamboge. This is a warm yellow, but I might change it. There's a little bit left. Yes. Okay, I'll change it to Australian Red Gold by Artist Spectrum. As you see, there's quite a few Artist Spectrum colours here. That's just because I have heaps of them from the Australian landscape set I got by them. They're 10 milliliter tubes. They last forever, and that's my reasoning there. Lots of these colors, I'm like using the last of them, so that's the plan. I don't actually know how interesting this will be to watch, but yeah. Some of these, like, I won't throw some of these colours away because I have a little bit of paint left in them. Oh, I love this colour so much. Cronaca and Rose by Winsor & Newton. It's a beautiful, beautiful colour. Such a nice, cool red. Using the last of it up. It shall be going to good use. Oh, no, not on my hand. As you can see, there's quite a range of brands and everything. And that's just because I like to experiment, you know. I don't like to just settle for what I know. I like to explore and try new things. So, yeah, I think there's a little bit of paint left in this one that I'll keep. And we've got Holbein, putting this in a palette finally. But yeah, I'm only putting a little bit in for the rest of them, as I said. But got Pearline Violet by Winsor & Newton. A lot of these haven't like been in a palette officially before, but I just haven't put a palette together for a while because I've been using half pans and everything, and half pans take ages to use. This is my only Van Gogh colour in a tube. I've got a Hooker's Green by them, but this is Permanent Blue Violet, which is a beautiful purple. Such a dark, dark colour. It's stunning. Then we've got Ultramarine Blue by Artist Spectrum. It's not my favourite ultramarine blue by any means, but I've got to use it up kind of thing. Yeah, that's the thinking. But I will need quite a bit of ultramarine blue. Let's just be honest there, because it's just such a useful colour. Then we've got Tasman Blue. Oh, I hate the smell of that ultramarine blue. For some reason, the ultramarine blue just stinks. Tasman Blue, another warm blue. That's why these two are together. They'll merge a bit. I'm so sorry to offend anyone with that. But these two are both warm blues, and I'm just like, I don't care enough. So just keep them separated, because I'll probably be mixing those colours a lot anyway. But these ones, I shall keep apart a little bit. I haven't used this palette in ages, and when I finished using this palette, I gave it like a nice clean out. So it's so weird using this one again. It's a really light palette, and honestly, I like it, but I've been using lots of metal tins recently. This is one of my last core tubes. Chromium oxide green. It's such a beautiful granulating green though. Oh, it's got a bit of separation, but that's okay. Flies at the moment are just awful because it's hot, muggy weather, so that's always fun. And now we've got another. We've got Australian Leaf Green. It's a bit of a mouthful, but it's good green. It looks really strange out of the tube, but it's gorgeous. And then we've got Australian Green Gold, another really nice green. I haven't used non-granulating greens for a while, but I thought I might as well use them since they're there. And this is one of my super granulating paints. This is Desert Orange. I thought it'd be a nice kind of warm brown to have. As you can see, my collection of browns is quite small in this set, but I figured mixing browns isn't hard to do, so I might as well just mix them. Then we've got Galaxy Pink, which is a good colour. It's very similar to Potter's Pink because it does in fact have Potter's Pink in it, I'm pretty sure. So that's there on the browns side. Then we've got a couple Daniel Smith colours. This is Bloodstone Genuine. New bit in there. And then for our kind of blacks slash greys, we have both granulating ones actually. I wonder if I should change that. Yeah. Nah. We've got Hematite, which is a very granulating one, and Mars Black, which is a very granulating black. So we're just, you know, the Hematite is much more of a grey black compared to Mars Black, which is much more of a black. So gonna have both of them down here, and yeah, that's my palette. Do I want to swatch them really quickly for you guys? maybe I will. I have a piece of paper here. I'll just grab some water, and then you guys won't notice, but I'll be back in a second. Okie dokie, let's swatch away. I've just grabbed some random watercolor paper, so it's nothing fancy. It's not cotton or anything. It's just your standard, just watercolour paper. Do some kind of flowery-ish swatches. They're pretty fun to do. And another disclaimer, these are straight from the tube. They will look different. Well, they'll work differently when they're like dry. They won't be like as pigmented. They will be pigmented because they're professional. They keep their colour really well, but they won't be this pigmented. Like, yeah, just letting you know. And also, I'm using different quantities of water and everything with them, so. Oh, I love this colour. Look how pretty it is. Permanent Red Winsor Newton. Love it. That would be a colour I'll buy again when I need a cool red. This probably should have been done by the browns, but it's okay. It's a nice red. Then we've got... Oh my god, I hear the chicken. You guys probably can't, thankfully, but I hear the chicken. There's a chicken here now, and I just... Every time I hear it, every time I just think of it, it's just, why a chicken? Here's the, it's just really nice purple, really strong colour. Will be a great mixing colour. My lovely ultramarine that I love so much and definitely am not going to be excited when I run out of. This colour, which is quite opaque, but it's like quite nice. Like, it's going to be a nice, similar to ultramarine mixing colour. That's my thinking with all these. It's like they're very bold colours by themselves, but they'll be amazing to mix with. I'm not even using that much water, which is good because it'd be a bit suspicious if I did use a lot of water with these kind of colours. Wonder if Minecraft is that sound copyrighted or something? The villager noise? I doubt it. Oh, look at that green. Stunning. My green line up here. Got the leafy green. The gold green. Stunning. I've got the brown, which is a bit of a sudden change. This will be a bit lighter, but it will be really nice granulating wise. Got the pinky brown. Galaxy. And I got three more. Got Bloodstone. Oh, gorgeous. We have got, I can't remember the name of this one. Hermitite. There we go. It's okay, guys. I'm not that much of an idiot. It's so granulating. I just can't believe it, really. Got Mars Black. But yeah, that's the beautiful swatch. I'll bring it close. Up close and personal. It's not dried yet. But it's still very pretty. But yeah, that is all I really wanted to show you guys, and hopefully you'll enjoyed it. I can see this is just from first view. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, potentially 9, 10, 11 granulating colours out of the however many colours I've ended up in this palette. I'm happy with the selection of colours, I'm excited to use it, and I'm excited to show you how useful it becomes. And I just realised, I don't know if you guys have, but I got blue everywhere, so it's gonna be fun for me to clean up. Thank you guys for watching. hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next video.